Studios, welcome to Tokyo Creative Talk. I'm your host, Shizuka Anderson, and today we don't have a guest. But don't worry, we have some great topics for you today. First off, we're going to be talking about sushi teleportation, or food teleportation. And if you're wondering what is that, as I was as well, there is a new concept where somewhere in the very near future, apparently, we're going to be able to teleport food, or at least the food data, so that we can reproduce it exactly in different countries. So I don't know if you've ever come to Japan and tried some sushi and it was amazing, and then you go back to your home country and you just miss it. There is a company called Team Open Meals that has this kind of concept invention where you can download food data and then basically send that like a downloadable file, and then it can be reproduced through a food printer in anywhere in the world. Basically, if you wanted to eat food that was made here in Japan, you can eat it right away in wherever you are, which is crazy. I can't even really totally grasp how it works, but it kind of makes sense because you can actually analyze in great detail the kinds of like food content and like chemical particles and compounds in food, and that could technically be compiled into data. So that's the whole idea, I guess. So this technology was first showcased at a technological event, I guess? Is that what it's called? Called South by Southwest. The idea is that you can actually reproduce through the food data, the texture, taste, and even the nutrients in the food. It's still in the conceptual phase, and they're working on it, but the time may come very, very soon where you will hear the words, "You've got meal." Okay, next topic. Speaking of things that are not yet real, there's a new project called Project Eevee from the world of Pokemon. I'm sure many of you are familiar with Pokemon. It's a very popular thing in Japan as well, even now. Not just among kids, but also apparently among adults, because this is a project where companies can apply to the Pokemon company to come have Eevee walk into your office and kind of sit in on meetings and just visit with people in the office. This is a giant Eevee mascot that comes walking in. And you can do, I guess you can ask Eevee to do different things. You can shake hands with Eevee, you can hug Eevee, take pictures. Eevee will even do some mild exercise. I don't know why that would be required, but apparently he works for you too. But I think this is a fun way to kind of increase work morale, but not only just to make the workplace more fun. Apparently, this is a good way for companies to promote themselves, because when Eevee comes to your office, the Eevee Project Twitter will kind of share what's going on in the office and report about the attractiveness of the company through Eevee's eyes, which I think is kind of fun. And followers of the account and fans of Eevee will therefore become more interested in those companies. So I think that's a really interesting idea. Most people think that working in Japanese companies might be a little bit like stressful, not so much fun, but here there's kind of a unique, fun way to make working more exciting. I would love to meet a giant fluffy Eevee too and hug it, because I always loved Eevee. So yeah, maybe follow that account, and if you want to see more famous like CEOs doing that, it could be kind of interesting. Let's bring him here. Let's call Project Eevee here. That would be so awesome. Maybe in a future video. So how was your hanami this year? Oh, you haven't been to Japan yet, you say? Well, don't worry, because we still have another fun flower festival, even though hanami is over now. So if you missed out on that, or the hanami was a tiny bit earlier this year, so you just didn't make it on time, if you're still around and you're gonna be here a little bit later on even, there is a great flower festival in a park called Showa, Kinen Park in Tachikawa, which is in Tokyo, but a little bit further away from the center. But it is gorgeous. It's a really, really big park, very spacious. They have all kinds of different flowers, like tulips, also possibly a few cherry blossoms left, and a lot of different kinds of colorful flowers. So it's great for if you want to take some of those like picturesque photos for your Instagram, if you do that kind of thing, this is probably the place to go. It actually started March 24th-ish, I think, March 24th, and it's going until end of May, May 27th. This is going on for quite some time, and you can also have a great picnic there, kind of like you're doing cherry blossom hanami, but it'll be a little bit of a different vibe because more different colors and just, you know, all around warm weather. So if you're looking for something fun like this, why not check it out and experience and absorb and enjoy the last bit of spring while you can before the dreadful heat of summer. It's only about 30 minutes from like Shinjuku Station by Chuo Line, so it's very convenient. Make sure to stop on by. That wraps things up for our Japan news for this week. I hope you enjoyed these topics and I hope they were useful for you. Please, as usual, leave some comments down below. I love reading them. Give some likes if you like the video. And of course, share as well because that would make me so happy. Anyway, see you guys again next time at Tokyo Creative Talk. This has been your host, Shizuka Anderson. Bye!